The University of Tennessee at Chattanooga and the SimCenter, National Center for Computational Engineering, introduced the Bloombox, a unit that uses fuel cell technology, at a ceremony held on the roof of Chattanooga's EPB headquarters.
We pride ourselves on embracing the dual responsibilities of educating our students at the same time that we promote economic development in the region. And I'm pleased to report that this project fulfills both goals richly.
The partnership between UTC's National SimCenter, Bloom Energy, EPB, TVA, and the Enterprise Center began in 2006. Research and testing of the Bloombox was led by Dr. Harry McDonald of the National SimCenter.
So what we did is we got one of their very, very early units. In fact, I think it was the second unit they ever made. And we got it and we brought it here and we tested it. We had our graduate students work on it and they did some research on it. And so the university started up a research program and evaluated their unit and found that it did work at that level. We had another question to answer, which is it reliable and can it scale up into a larger unit? And that's what our current phase of activity is.
The Bloombox is a 100 kilowatt energy server that uses solid oxide fuel cell technology developed by California's Bloom Energy. It provides energy for EPB's downtown headquarters 24 hours a day, 365 days a year.
This is a great part of America's future, and 60 Minutes demonstrated it with KR to the world. He had kept it close to the vest for a long period of time, but now the world knows about it, and certainly Chattanooga is very proud to be the first place in the eastern United States that a 100 kilowatt system is actually installed and functional.
Air, as you all know, anywhere on the planet has enough oxygen, and that oxygen from the air goes from this black side and comes to this other side. On this side, you need a fuel, any fuel that has hydrogen or carbon or both. And that's practically everything you can think about, from fossil fuels like natural gas that we have plenty of in this country, to biogas, to waste gas from water treatment facilities, to biomass like switchgrass and bagasse from sugarcane and wheat straw and rice straw, anything that you can think about.
McDonald and his team at the National SimCenter will continue to monitor the performance of the Bloombox. He said working with Bloom Energy was a fantastic opportunity for the university.
There are so few people across the nation understand this technology. They have instant opportunity, and by virtue of having worked with the Bloombox, they have instant credibility. So it's a great opportunity for our students.